He was holding back, he wasn't being cooperative, he wasn't giving me the information I needed, evasive, and finally I felt that he was playing games.
There is so much evidence in this situation, setting aside any anecdotal testimony from any witness out there, from anybody who's been in one of these facilities, the evidence as to how the system operates in and of itself is illegal.
Play it up the fuck with morning. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. fellow Americans, I come before you tonight as a candidate for Vice President, and as a man whose honesty and integrity has been questioned. Is to either ignore the
But even this is no longer enough. We are in the era of the thermonuclear bomb that can obliterate cities and can be delivered across continents. With such weapons, war has become not just tragic, but preposterous. With such weapons, there can be no victory for anyone. Plainly, the objective now is to see that such a war does not occur at all. And so the third imperative of peace is this. Without for a moment relaxing our internal and collective defense, we must actively try to bridge the great chasm that separates from the people under communist rule. In those regions are millions of individuals and beings who have been our friends, who themselves have sincerely wanted peace and freedom and life. We are beginning to be able, cautiously, with our eyes open, to encourage some interchange of ideas, a book, magazine, student, tourists, artists, radio program, technical experts, religious leaders.